In today's video, we are going to go over a debt payoff tracker designed in Google Sheets. This is designed to be very easy to use. It works from January. However, you can update it from whatever month you're starting. It's also only one page, meaning that you can see everything related to all of your debts in one Google Sheets. If you are interested in purchasing this template, I'll leave a link in the description box below where you can go ahead and purchase it. By the way, I do have this debt payoff tracker available in multiple colors. So here's the one that is a pink monochrome color. So it's the same color across the board. And the other version, which is multicolor, each color represents each debt. So these two, as well as the monochrome option, are available for sale. For this demo, I will use the monochrome option to show you how it works. If you want to get some inspiration on how to create your own Google Sheets debt payoff tracker, keep watching. We're starting with the overview area, the debt overview table. We have here the different types of debt, the minimum payment that's due every month, the balance you start out with, the ending balance, and the interest rates. Moving on, we can see two pie charts that represent a breakdown of the different debts. Down here, we have a graph that shows you the starting balance right next to the ending balance, so you can see them side by side for each of the debts that you have. Moving on to the second area, starting with the top, we have the starting balance, so everything that you're starting out with, the total ending balance, so how much you currently owe, everything put together, so an aggregate of what you started out with and what you currently owe, how much you've paid up to date, and the percentage that you've paid off. So this will turn green once you've paid off at least 50% of your debt. Let's say I change a value here. You can see that this automatically turns red. So it activates to green, which is a good thing if you've paid off 50% of your debt. Starting out with the individual areas, this first table is the mortgage, but you can really name it whatever you want. It goes based on the order that you have here. And here we have the interest, minimum payment, starting and ending balances. We have a graph that gives you a visual representation of the starting and the ending balances. And finally, we have a table that represents the amount that will be paid off each month. We have the same table for student loans, car loans, credit cards, and the rest of the debts that's owed. With that said, I'm going to show you how to start off from a blank debt payoff tracker to show you how everything works. All right, so this is what the blank debt payoff tracker looks like. And if you purchase it, this is what it would look like. A word of caution, you do not want to update this area. You have to leave it blank. If you touch this area, there are formulas here that will change how the calculations work. So you don't want to edit anything that is here. So we'll start out by adding the different types of debts. All right, now that we've updated the debt type, you can see that it automatically updates right here. So you never need to change the names here, because once you change it here, it automatically updates here in the same order. Next, we'll fill out the minimum payment column. Just like the debt area, you can see that the minimum payment automatically updates the individual debt areas. So again, you never really need to update anything here. As long as it's inputted here, it automatically updates in this section. All right, so now we'll add the starting balances for each of the debt types. After adding the starting balance, you see that the remaining balance and the starting balance are updated automatically here, as well as the ending balance here. You do not want to touch this table because, like I said before, what happens is that this automatically changes once you make payments every month. The last column would be to add the interest, and I'll just quickly add that so you can see how everything comes together. All right, so now that we've completed this entire table, the only thing left would be to update your payments monthly. So let's say for the month of January, for the condo, we paid $5,000. This changes the ending balance. So again, this is why you don't have to do anything here, because it automatically updates. Once you add your starting balance, it changes the amount that's left. It updates right here and it changes the graph. The same applies to the next loan. So let's say for the student loan, we pay $1,000. you can see that everything automatically updates on its own. I'll go ahead and add a few more payments for the condo so you can see how the graph changes automatically. With additional payments, it automatically calculates how much has been paid off, as well as updating the graph area. All right, so I hope this was helpful. If you want to purchase this spreadsheet, I'll leave a link in the description box area. If you want to create your own and you have questions about what I did and the formulas I used, let me know in the comment section below. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you in the next video.